In this tutorial, I will go deeper into ReTrack Affinity Engine and Selective Tracking. I will build and retrack a skeleton inside the guy. I have drawn the mask's skeleton already. Let's track all the masks. Okay. As you see, the tracking failed and many joints don't stick as they should. Here, here. The face mask is tracked well thanks to the contrast in the face and because it's a closed mask. Well, I hide the layer and I select a layer where I've already tracked several masks. The masks are all closed, so the tracker is able to track the area inside each mask and the tracking is more reliable. I also track the body where there is contrast, and it helps a lot to achieve a good track. To show you how effective it is, I'm gonna track one last mask the same way. On the hand, position, scale and rotation, forward and backward. It works well, fast and effective. Okay, let's select all the masks and also an already processed face tracking effect. Well, I start from the face and select and retrack without selection. It's not working because these points here and also here are badly tracked. So I'm gonna try by selecting solid tracked points. The one on the chin, a couple around the lips and on the eyebrows here. Retrack. As you see, the mask is not following the broken tracks anymore. How does ReTrack Affinity Engine works? Well, for each vertex, the algorithm chooses two or more points among all the existing or selected ones based on proximity and angle. So, let's make an example with this vertex. The chosen points are probably these, and this one. For the chin vertex, instead, ReTrack gets the chin point alone because it is so close that it assumes it's the most reliable. This vertex, I guess these three points. After choosing the best points, the engine triangulates the mask positions over time. Let's get back to the face and done. Press G to select the pen tool and draw the vertebral column. ReTrack. This vertex is not aligned, so I select some points close to each vertex. For the bad tracked vertex, I try these two points, so the triangulation will be between these three points. ReTrack. And now it works. I show you a trick. Oh, sorry, done, so I can unlock the mask. Select the mask, and I can use the edit tool while I'm working on the retracking as long as the mask is tracked. I refine the middle vertex. When I close the edit tool panel, the tracking panel is still operating. Better. Okay, I work on the right arm. Perfect. Left arm. It works. Now the right hand. I don't like it. So I try with a proximity points selection. Just two points. Oh, much better. The left hand. this join doesn't work well. So points selection. I'm not sure about the points, so I'm gonna try these ones. ReTrack. No, I have to edit it manually. So done. Select the mask and edit. Okay, much better. Now, what about these connections? Well, because the end of these masks are already tracked, I will use them to connect the arms and the body. I set the retracted masks on a new layer, so I have all the retracted masks on a clean layer. I select only the masks I need. And track. I draw a mask precisely on the points. Select and retrack. Because they are very much on the points, the engine will retrack each mask vertex using only the closest point data. Perfect. I set the mask on the same layer. The skeleton tracking is complete and fully working. So now I add the stroke to render the lines. And a couple of glow effects for the light effect. The last step, cover the light on the hands. In order to do that, I have to retrack a new mask on the hands. Draw, select and retrack. I can do better than that. Because the mask is on the hands, I select only the points on the hands. It should stick. Retrack. Okay, better. I set the mask on a new layer and then I put the layer above the light skeleton. Of course, I have to set the mask mode to add. So, in descending order, hands, skeleton, body. Just a last check. Oh, look, the masked hands need some adjustment. Let's add some feather. I expand the mask only on the right side. Because this is the only virtual key, the editing works on all the tracked keyframes. Let's check again. Well, perfect. So, in a nutshell, remember, you can use the edit tool even during the retracking process. About the engine, if the temp mask vertex is on a retracking point, the engine will use as a reference just that point. Otherwise, it will use the two or three closest selected points. If you are in trouble with the tracking, try to select the reliable points that are inside the drawn mask you are working on. That's all, guys.